Hello everyone, I'm very happy to be here today. My name is Sophie Vos and today I will share some of my results from my master thesis of which I've been working over the past 5 months. This thesis is about energy efficiency in the public cloud. The thesis is made in collaboration with Schubert Files and the Vrije Universiteit Amsterdam. For everyone who has been following the news, it is hard to have missed these pressing calls after the release of the latest IPCC report. We have to reduce our greenhouse gas emissions in order to prevent the negative effects of global warming. Naturally, each sector has to look inward to see what their share is in this problem. Over here, we see the greenhouse gas emissions of our sector, the ICT sector. We see that the global greenhouse gas emissions from the ICT sector are around 2.5%. This might seem like a small percentage, but first of all, we see that this trend is increasing over time. And second of all, this is a similar footprint to the aviation industry prior to COVID. The next question that we need to ask is why does the IT sector have such a large greenhouse gas emission footprint? This is mainly due to the electricity that is being used by the computers. Because the ICT sector is so large, we need to understand which parts of the ICT sector emit most greenhouse gases. If we see this chart over here, we see that the largest share is from data centers. And also, if you compare the share of data centers from 2010 and 2020, then we see that the share is also increasing over time. This increase of data centers goes hand in hand with another trend, namely the rising popularity of the public cloud, as illustrated by these figures. The public cloud is expected to contribute to reducing the energy consumption of data centers by letting multiple users share resources and also by investing in renewable energy and the benefits from economies of scale. This brings us to the context of our thesis. So we have cloud consumers that migrate their software in the public cloud. However, this cloud is still facilitated by actual data centers, which are powered by electricity. So we previously established that migrating your workload to the cloud is expected to have a positive effect on your energy consumption. However, the consumers are now so abstracted away from their electricity usage that previously they received an energy bill each month, so they're very aware of their energy consumption. But now, because of the abstraction that the cloud forms between the consumers and the electricity usage, they have less incentives to reduce this, because how can you optimize something that you cannot measure? Still, these cloud consumers aim to reduce their energy consumption to be more sustainable or to save costs. Unfortunately, at the moment, the major cloud providers do not provide direct feedback regarding the energy consumption of individual cloud workloads. That brings us to our research question, namely, how can cloud consumers architect energy efficient software in the public cloud? In order to guide cloud users for energy efficiency, we discover tactics for resource efficiency. And based on these, we constructed a model for potential tactics for energy efficiency. These tactics are based on interviews with practitioners at Schubert Files. This is the model that we created. We divided the tactics for energy efficiency into three categories, namely resource monitoring, that involves how can we understand how much energy consumption the resources actually consume; resource allocation, that is involved with the scheduling of the resources and the tasks among the resources; and then lastly, resource adaptation, that is involved with changing the resources to increase the energy efficiency. We don't have time to go through each tactic in depth at the moment, but if you're interested, please feel free to read the full thesis. All the tactics are explained over there, but now I will highlight a few of them. First of all, the tactic, experiment to discover the optimal architecture. These tactics are really hard to apply to each case. Some of them are really case dependent. So it is always important for cloud consumers to experiment in order to find which of the architects is best fitting for their particular use case. The cloud is very beneficial for this purpose because it is relatively easy to compare several architectures without the need for prior investment and configurations. The next tactic that I wish to discuss is apply auto-scaling. This involves scaling the resource usage to the actual demand. If this is done properly, we will not waste energy anymore on resources that will just run idle. In the second phase of this research, we looked at a method to estimate the energy consumption in the public cloud. We found the Cloud Carbon Footprint tool. This is an open source tool funded by ThoughtWorks that estimates the energy consumption in the public cloud. They also introduce a user-friendly interface where you can keep track of your carbon emissions and energy consumption over time. This is estimated based on the billing data as provided by the cloud provider and then transformed into the estimated energy consumption. But there is, of course, a main limitation when using this method because this is an estimation that is based on assumptions rather than direct measurements. In the last phase of our research, we conducted a case study around one of the tactics, namely the tactics apply edge computing. We looked at a case study of a fall detection system in a nursing home that involves camera images that record the patient. And then using machine learning classification, they will send a signal that if someone fell down to send the appropriate help. When architecting the system, we identified two scenarios. You can either send all the data from the camera images directly to the cloud, as illustrated in scenario two, or you can place an edge device near the camera that actually already classifies the images, whether someone fell down or not, and then only the events will be sent to the cloud. For this scenario, we are interested in whether using this edge device has a positive effect on the energy consumption. That is why we focus on these two yellow parts, because they differ in both scenarios, and for each of them, we estimate the energy consumption. We found that applying edge computing can save energy, especially because the cameras generates a large volume of images. And when you have to send them directly to the cloud over the internet, this costs a lot of energy. This energy can be saved if you already process it on the edge and then only having to send signals, for example, whenever someone fell down to the clouds. This brings me to the take-home message. First of all, we really want to urge cloud providers to provide more feedback to their cloud consumers regarding their energy consumption and overall sustainability. Because the cloud consumers only get the billing data, so they will optimize their workload for this. But if they receive more feedback regarding, for example, their energy consumption, they can take this quality attribute energy consumption into account. Next to this, we have shown that it is also possible that the cloud consumers can already estimate their energy consumption in the cloud by using, for example, the Cloud Carbon Footprint tool. Lastly, using these tactics for resource efficiency is a great heuristic to actually find ways to architect the workload for energy efficiency. Thank you so much for paying attention and listening to the results. I really hope that together we can make the cloud a bit greener. And if you're interested in the full thesis or have other questions, please feel free to reach out using the link below. Thank you.